The one who reveals the secrets from life's smallest building blocks inside cells can then stop diseases such as Alzheimer's and ALS. Gunnar von Heijne is one such researcher, dedicating his life to uncovering a detail which can not only rescue us from disease, but also explain how life itself works.
I've always been curious about how the world works, and I still am 50 years down the line. As a scientist, I've chosen to focus on the tiniest events inside the cell.
Since Gunnar began his research nearly 50 years ago, he has been working toward understanding the life inside our cells. And for the last 20, working to reveal the mechanism by which proteins, which are created in the cell, get their unique shape. How they are folded, as they say. A very small detail, but vitally important. We often associate proteins with what we eat. It's found in meat and beans. But proteins are so much more than that. They are what make our bodies function. They build up bones, muscles. They are hormones and antibodies. Proteins are created inside cells, more precisely within the ribosomes, the cell's small factories. Here, proteins are assembled from amino acids in different combinations depending on which protein is to be produced. A long chain of linked amino acids is formed. As the chain is on its way out of the ribosome, some amino acids wedge themselves together, giving the proteins their own unique shape. It's precisely this action that Gunnar wants to understand. Because if proteins fold incorrectly, they clump together with whatever is outside the ribosome, which can lead to diseases like Alzheimer or ALS.
The better we understand protein folding, the better is the chance that we can develop drugs against these diseases. Yeah, I think we're closing in on what we want to do, right? That's a good idea. Right.
Gunnar and his team want to solve the mystery of what is going wrong when a protein doesn't fold as it should.
Okay, that's for the core.
Could there be something wrong with the combination of amino acids? To understand this, they make new recipes for proteins.
And we could also do a less.
When we study the folding of a particular protein, we design different variants of the protein by changing amino acids, changing combinations of amino acids in the protein, and looking at how they interact with each other during the folding process. And in that way, we reach a better understanding of what actually happens when the protein folds.
But Gunnar's recipe would be worthless without the help of other researchers who are also working to understand these crucial details of life. Gunnar's research became particularly successful after reading an article by a researcher in Japan about a stopper.
And he had discovered a short segment in a protein that had the amazing ability to stop protein synthesis on the ribosome. And when we thought about that for a while, we realized that maybe we could use that fragment to study protein folding, which was our interest.
When Gunnar starts the process, a chain of amino acids is assembled that moves down through the ribosome's so-called channel. At the end of the chain is a combination of amino acids that together form the stopper, which sticks to the walls of the channel. As more and more amino acids cluster into each other, the entire chain begins to push against the walls, so much so that the stopper eventually releases. Different protein chains take a different amount of time to fold and tear away the stopper. And from this process, Gunnar can gather data about how the folding is taking place.
So the final result of our experiments are actually these columns of numbers. They don't look much, but from them we can make graphs like this one. And this graph tells us a lot about protein folding in the ribosomes. And then we realized that maybe we can take this one step further and actually see the protein fold inside the ribosome with our own eyes.
Thanks to a new high-tech electron microscope, Gunnar can actually see how amino acid combinations pull together and become a protein.
This is a real ribosome. This is what they look like. Inside here is the tunnel through which the new protein emerges into the world. And we can see, if we make a cross-section, we can actually see the new protein chain. And here is the newly folded protein. So this is what the birth of a protein looks like.
For almost 50 years, the scientific world has been trying to understand how the folding of proteins occurs. And now, thanks in part to Gunnar's research, we are beginning to get a really good understanding of the process.
We could do very conservative.
Not only will this knowledge end up in textbooks, it will also give the next generation of researchers tools to be able to develop medicines and treatment methods for, among other things, ALS and Alzheimer's.
What feels good is to think that we have provided at least a couple of pieces to this big puzzle that science is trying to solve about how life works. And also, kind of on a personal level, to realize that, yes, I do know a little bit more about life than when we started out. And that's a good feeling.